What's up, Facebook world? How's everybody doing today? I would like to welcome you back to another live REI caregiver moment. My name is Kion Church, aka the Big Hearted Caregiver. What I do is I help voluntary family caregivers to become paid caregivers through our personal assistance service agency called Reliable Aid Inc. Now, today's episode is all about how do you clear the house for the virus before you take your parents or your loved ones in there. We're not trying to let nobody get sick on a visit, especially on a nice Saturday like today. You know what I mean? The tornado's gone, hurricane, whatever it was. Nice day today. We're talking Saturdays. And we want to know how can we get in and out the house and still stay corona free. Now listen, before I get into that, if you or anybody you know would like to work with us at Reliable Aid Inc. personally, write in the comments, get started, and someone will personally get back to you. I'm going to see to it ASAP or dapper. Now, listen, really important right now. You know what I mean? A lot of people thinking like this corona thing is over. You know what I mean? It's still kind of scary, and everybody really doesn't know how to play it. So I'm going to give you my personal three. You know what I mean? Three big questions that you're going to ask people when going into their house. And that's going to let you know right then and there, you know, whether it's a safe place to visit. You know what I mean? Should I be going in there? Should I be taking my parents in there? You know, because even if it's not a safe place and you got to go in, you definitely don't want to, you know, jeopardize your parents or your loved ones. So here we go. The first three questions that you should ask somebody, has anyone in your household been diagnosed with the COVID? Then you do like this. Check it out. You wait to see what they're going to say, man, because you don't want to just let that answer go by. You know what I mean? That's very important. You always want to ask. First question, has anybody in the household been diagnosed with the COVID? Now, hopefully, you're going to get the green light, which is a no. All right, then you're going to ask another question. Has you or anybody in your house been told to quarantine? I don't know. My English is a little bad, but guess what? Listen, I know if you need to stay in the house, I don't need to be with you. So that's question number two. The third question is the most big question that, you know, we all need to know. Before I come in there, has you or anybody else been, what's the word I'm looking for? Have you or anybody else experienced any symptoms of the COVID-19? Now, that's the strongest question to me on the books. You know what I mean? You may not have it. You know, you may not be diagnosed with it. You may not have been told to quarantine because you had it. But you are experiencing a couple symptoms. Now, I got to think about it. Hey, KC, is this a place that we really want to go into? You know, they in there coughing and stuff, man. We ain't doing it like that. You know, I'm going to tell you the truth. It's just me and me. Just me and my pop. I take care of my father. You know what I mean? Pop can't, you know, I can't give it to him. So I got to be mindful of places that I go. You know, they say the COVID, you know, it won't get into your body unless you touch your eyes or your nose or your mouth or something like that. But at the same time, it's still strong enough to stick onto your clothes and then you can take it wherever you're going. So we definitely don't want to do that. So three big questions before you go into the people's house this weekend. Has anybody here been diagnosed with the COVID? Number two, have anybody here been told to quarantine? Number three, is anybody here experiencing symptoms of the COVID-19? Now look, that's it from the Big Hearted Caregiver. That's all the info you need to know to properly, safely, you know, go on in there, make sure everything's cool. Because we got a lot of friends and family who we like to go see on the weekends. We just want to be safe. All we want to do is play it safe. I ain't trying to hurt nobody. You know what I mean? So look, if you need anything else, man, all you got to do is check me out on anchor.fm/ The Big Hearted Caregiver. Now, that's the podcast. I give up all the secrets, the tips, the tricks, everything daily. I think we publishing over there daily. So, you know what I mean? Also, check me out on YouTube. You know what I mean? Reliable Aid Inc. It's the YouTube channel. You know, let me know anytime you're here with me. Don't be afraid to smash the wild face and also put in the comments where you watching this broadcast from. You a big-hearted caregiver just like me? Let me know. Let me know. Hashtag your city, hashtag your state, hashtag live, hashtag whatever you need. Look, also sign up for the live notifications. You know what I mean? Don't be afraid to like and share any topics, any comments, any questions, anything you got for me. You know, put it in the lines. Now listen, Reliable Aid Inc. is your personal assistance professionals. We watch over your family just like they were ours because we care that much. Give me a chance to earn your business. 302-689-3240, 302-689-3240. We are your personal assistance professionals. And remember, What I do is I help family members with distressed loved ones to become paid caregivers through our personal assistance service agency. So if anybody asks you, what does Reliable Aid do, you can tell them. Look, if you want to get paid being the caregiver that you already are, let me know, all right? I'm down to help you. I'm down to, you know, set your family a little financially more better on their feet. You know what I mean? Because that's what we all need. It's easy to take care of people if you got a good heart, but you might need the finances to go with it. 302-689-3240. Thank you for hanging out with me this long. I love you. Talk to you tomorrow.